4, verses 23 and 24, which he says, "But the hour is coming, and now here, when the true worshippers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeks such as these to worship him. God is spirit, and those who worship him must worship in spirit and in truth." Join me, please, for a word of prayer. Faithful and loving God, whose words are true to this day, to your people. And they are true each and every day. Your resurrection has affirmed our belief in your words, and also our belief in your deeds. We are comforted by knowing that your Holy Spirit is always with us, guiding us each moment in life. These we declare in and through your resurrected Son, Jesus Christ, and we say, Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Friends, let us continue with our worship by referring to our bulletin on our call to worship. And can I request you to read the parts in light print while I begin by reading the parts in bold print. The book of Acts, chapter 16, verse 31, the Bible says, "They said, believe in the Lord Jesus and you will be saved, you and your household." John chapter 11, verse 40. "Did I not say to you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God?" Amen. Amen. Friends, we'll now request you if we could rise, if you're able, and to sing our opening hymn. We'll request you to just sing one verse, and then we'll let's sing that together. Praise the Lord. Go through these times, we know, Lord, that your Son has appeared to the people around him after he was raised from the dead. As we come together today, we seek that you continue to reassure us with your words, with your spirit, as we seek comfort from you and guidance for the way ahead. May your mighty hands continue to lead us through the difficult times ahead, times of challenges, times of hopelessness, times of fear. As people come to us with questions about the truth of your resurrection, Lord, guide us through our difficult situations. Dear Lord, instill in us hope as we look to you for every step of the way in life. We lift our eyes towards you, Lord, as you guide us with your Spirit and with your love. This is our prayer, offered in and through the mighty name of our Lord, who was raised from the dead, Jesus Christ, our Savior, and all your people say, Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Eat. This is my body is my blood of a new covenant, given for you and for the many, for the forgiveness of sin. Each time you drink it, do it in remembrance of me. And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ. out your hand and put it in my side. Do not doubt, but believe.
Thomas answered him.